Hello, today we're going to make rectangular or square pieces of fabric. We will use it to make flags. Inflate balloons leaving about 3-inch flat tail to make rows. We are going to use a pair of balloons to make each row in this example. So let's tie nozzles of two balloons together in one knot. Prepare as many pairs of balloons as many rows you want to make. Also, we will use different set of balloons, in this example clear or gray color, to connect all rows together. Inflate these balloons leaving about 6-inch flat tails. In this example, we are going to twist all bubbles for each row of the same about 6-inch size. Fold the first pair of balloons together, twist and lock first bubbles in one move. Lock the nozzle of the first clear connection balloon with the ends of the red bubbles. We twist the rest of the row in the same fashion. Just for this instruction, I didn't attach the connection balloon on the left side of the sculpture. We're going to do it later. At the very end of the row, we twist bubbles half size of the regular size bubbles that we make the row with. To increase the size of the row, we can always add a new pair of balloons at the end. Working in this fashion, we can make sculpture of any large size. Okay, let's twist the last, in our example, about 3-inch size bubbles. So that's the size of our sculpture. Four bubbles, or should I say 3.5. Here I lock the nozzle of the last clear connection balloon with the end of the first row. To make this fabric, we have to place the short, the half-size bubbles of the second row on the upper side, the left side of the sculpture. Before we start the second row, let's cut off the rest of the red balloons of the first row and tie off the ends. You can trim the ends of the balloons with scissors or just hide it between bubbles. That's it. We have made the first row. It looks the same from the front and from the back side. We can work the sculpture from left or right side. It really doesn't matter. Twist the first clear about 1-inch size bubble of the first connection balloon on the right side of the sculpture. Lock the free end of the first clear bubble with the nozzles of the second row red balloons. Place the next clear connection balloon between red balloons of the second row and twist the first regular size bubbles of the second row. Once again, we start the second row from the upper side of the sculpture. Working in this way, we will end the row by making the short bubbles on the upper side of the sculpture. Work in this fashion to the end of the second row. Always place the corresponding connection balloon between balloons of the row. In this example, I want to make flag of Colombia. Obviously, we can use different colors to make different color patterns. Okay, and here we have to twist the last short about 3-inch size bubbles of the second row. Just for purpose of this instruction, I'm going to use different color gray connection balloons to lock bubbles of the second row. Here's a gray connection balloon. And once again, I will lock bubbles on this side of the sculpture with connection bubbles a bit later. To make this size sculpture, we're going to use total of 8 connection balloons. So far, we attached only 7 connection balloons. You have to pull the second row balloons as close to the first row as you can. As I mentioned before, we can start the row from either side of the sculpture, left, right, it doesn't matter. Only important part is where you place the short bubbles. So let's twist the second clear 1-inch bubble on the same side where we started the second row. Plug the free end of the second clear bubble with the nozzles of the balloons of the third row. I use the blue colors here. Twist the first clear about 2-inch size bubble of the next connection balloon. Now we have to twist the first short bubbles of the third row. At the same time, we lock them with corresponding connection bubble. The next gray connection balloon we place between row balloons. Twist the next clear connection bubble. Twist the next regular size row bubbles and lock the free ends with corresponding connection bubble. Work in this fashion to the end of the row. As a matter of fact, we work entire sculpture using this technique. I'm going to fast play next part of this video clip because we basically repeat the same thing over and over. The size of the connection bubbles we twist actually less than 2-inch. I make the free end of the connection bubble in about the same level as the top edge of the previous row. This way we make no gaps between rows. So the last couple rows we've been working from the same side of the sculpture. We started the previous row with the short bubble. So now we start this row with a regular size bubble. And as you already know, we always twist the same size connection bubbles, 1-inch, at the side of the sculpture. Alright, so far we have made 4 rows, 2 red and 2 blue rows. And now it's time to make 3 more yellow rows. So we are going to make total of 7 rows. 7 is odd number. It means that the first and the last row will look exactly the same. I think it's kind of good. In this example, I use 2 sets, 2 colors of connection balloons. I think it makes it easier to follow the instructions. However, to make the sculpture look better, you should probably use just 1 color connection balloons. I would suggest you to use only clear color connection balloons. Also, it may work really well if you use the same colors connection balloons as the background color. Alright, let's get back to our sculpture. Here's the end of the 7th row. Let's use the brown color connection balloon at the side of the sculpture to represent the flagpole. Attach the nozzle of the brown balloon between bubbles of the top yellow row on the side of the sculpture. We twist all brown bubbles of the same 1-inch size. As we proceed from the top to the bottom, cut off the rest of the row balloons and tie off the ends. So why are we doing it now? Why didn't we connect the rows when we were making the rows? I'm absolutely agree with you. It makes more sense to connect 2 rows between each other once we make those rows. That's the way we're actually supposed to do if we want to make just 1 flag, nothing else. However, it makes much easier to connect open side of our sculpture to some other sculptures. Or just to make a corner of a sculpture. Instead of cut off ends of the row balloons, we can use them to keep twisting the rows. In this way, we can use it to make any kind of sculptures. And I mean very large sculptures as well. I'm not going to show it today. Let's save it for future instructions. but I think you got the idea anyway. Alright, now it's time to cut off the rest of the connection balloons, tie off the ends, hide them between bubbles, or trim them with scissors. I think this sculpture is kind of heavy to use one balloon flagpole, unless if you want to attach it to a wall somehow. I'm going to cut off the rest of the brown balloon as well. Congratulations! We have made the piece of fabric. We used three colors to represent the flag of Colombia. In the next example, we are going to make a flag of Israel. It is going to be a bit larger size sculpture. This time I'm making five bubbles long row. I use clear color connection balloons. Also, I'm going to use only one set of connection balloons. Working this way, we save just four balloons on this piece of fabric alone. Plus we save time, that's most importantly. Of course, there are going to be small yet visible gaps in the fabric. If you have enough balloons, enough time, and you want to really make the sculpture look perfect, then you should use two sets of connection balloons. That's absolutely the best way. So, using one set of connection balloons, we actually can connect only every other row. We can work in this fashion to make any size large sculptures, but the sculpture must have odd number of rows. It is quite important limitation, especially if we work on color designs. Making large size sculptures is very time consuming process. There is not much we can do about this, maybe just a couple of things. First of all, it's good to use electrical air pump when you have to inflate a big number of balloons. And of course, working in a team with another balloon twisters, that's the best thing you can do. You can always invite some friends, family, to help you make large size sculptures. Any big sculptures can be split on parts. You work on one part, your friends work on another part, and then you assemble the sculpture. Pretty much simple like that. And most importantly, you'll get more fun working with people than doing the same sculpture alone. Make yourself happy, make other people happy. It is the most important idea of balloon twisting art. Alright, back to our sculpture. Here I finish in the last row, and now we have to, as always, cut off the rest of the balloons and tie off the ends, hide them between bubbles. That's it, we have made the piece of fabric. Now I'm going to use blue color permanent marker to draw the star, 6-point star or Star of David. Congratulations, we have made the flag of Israel. In the next example, we are going to make a flag of India. I want to make smaller size flag, so we can use one balloon to make one row. Let's twist regular row bubbles about 4-inch size, and the short bubbles about 2-inch size. So here I twist a chain of 3 regular size bubbles, then 2 short bubbles, and then chain of 3 regular size bubbles, total 8 bubbles. Also, I'm going to use the rest of the balloon to make connection on the side of the sculpture. Now let's lock both ends of the chain of the first 8 bubbles, then we lock free end of the first bubble with free end of the 8th bubble. Attach nozzle of the clear connection balloon at this point. Fix the rest of the row in the same fashion. I have already prepared balloon for the second row. So now we just have to twist the ninth, about 1 inch bubble of the second balloon. Then we lug its free end between the short bubbles of the first balloon. Let's finish up with the first row. That's it, now we have to fix the second row. Fix one connection balloon at a time. Place it between corresponding bubbles of the second row, lock the free ends, and work this way to the end of the row. When we get closer to the end of the second row, we twist the ninth 1-inch bubble of the first row and lock it between short bubbles of the second row. After that, we lock free ends of the last pair of second row bubbles. Now we can cut off the rest of the green balloons, tie off the ends and hide them between bubbles, and attach the second set of clear connection balloons. Attach the nozzle of the third balloon on a side between the bubbles of the second row, twist the first 1-inch connection bubble. Then we work our way, making one side of the third row from beginning to the end of the row. At the end of the row, we will turn and work our way from the end row to the beginning of the row to make the second side of the row. Basically, we're going to work the rest of the sculpture in the same fashion. Attach the nozzle of the fourth balloon between bubbles of the second row. Twist 1-inch connection bubble, lock the free end between bubbles of the third row. Twist the second 1-inch connection bubble of the fourth balloon. And now we work the fourth row in the same fashion as we did the third row, one side at a time. And we use the end of the third balloon to make the connection on the other side of the row. Cut off the rest of the white balloons, tie off the ends, hide them between bubbles. Use orange balloons to make the next two rows. We do it in the same fashion, exactly the same fashion as we did the previous rows. Using one balloon to make both sides of one row, it's not the easiest or fastest way to work, definitely not. We save a couple balloons here, but it takes longer to make the sculpture. It is just an example of how we can make basically the same thing using less balloons. Once you make the sixth row, cut off the rest of the balloons. Here I use a permanent marker to draw a symbol of the Indian flag. Congratulations again, we have made three flags. Flag of India, flag of Colombia, and here's a flag of Israel. Let's put them next to each other so we can see the difference in the sizes. Have fun and happy twisting!